Hello everybody, I am E. Krishnarao Patro, Associate Professor in the Department of CSC. So, today we will discuss about an important topic, that is circular queue. In the previous session, we have seen the linear queue. The linear queue, circular queue, everything comes under linear data structure. So, when I say queue, queue follows always an order. That is nothing but first in, first out. The name indicates whichever element comes first, it will process first. So, when it follows the order, first in, first out, immediately you can say it is a queue. So, the queue can be a linear queue or the queue can be a circular queue. Actually, I can say queues are broadly two kinds. One is linear queue, second one is circular queue. In the case of linear queue, it goes from left to right in an order. Whereas, when I say circular queue, it also goes in a linear pattern, but the representation will be in a cyclic pattern. That means you can represent the data in a cyclic form. But in a computer system, everything is linear only. Because when I say cycle, for example, here I will say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, 7 elements are there. Now, these 7 elements are represented in a cyclic form. Same thing in a computer system, in a memory, it will represent like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, but in imagination, you will feel as if it is a cyclic. So, in a computer system, everything is in a linear pattern only. But our imagination is in a cyclic way. So, let us see the definition. The circular queue is also a linear data structure which follows the principle of FIFO. Whether it is a linear queue or circular queue, both follows FIFO order only. First in, first out order only. But instead of ending the queue at the last position, because if I go in a linear queue, it will end at this end, at the end. Whereas in the cyclic way, that means circular queue, it again starts from the first position. That means after 7, it will come to this place. Because here, after 7 again comes to here, 1th place. It goes here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, again 7. Where in the linear, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It ends here. That means it will go again forward only. It will not come backward. Where in the cyclic, it will go in again. After 7, it will come 1 only. Because it is in a cyclic pattern. So, instead of ending at a queue at the last position, it again starts from first position. After the last, hence making the queue, we have like a circular data structure. Actually, there is nothing called circular data structure. Everything is either linear or non-linear. So, your circular queue comes under linear data structure. Most of the time, in exam, they may ask a question, circular queue is what kind of data structure? Whether it is a linear or non-linear? Your answer is linear only. Why linear? Because in computer system, everything will be stored in a sequential manner. That's why it is a linear data structure. Fine? Or I may give like this. 1, 2, 3. This is in a cyclic form. Same thing I can represent in a linear form. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. This is also a linear pattern of the same thing. But here if you use cyclic, then there is a efficient usage of memory. If there is no other data will come, only in the same memory if you want to utilize, then always go for a cyclic or circular queue. If at all you need some extra memory, then go for linear. But same memory if you want to utilize, always go for circular. Now you can see a diagrammatic pattern. The queue is not a linear, but circular. The queue is not a linear, but it is a circular in nature. In imagination. But if you go physically to the computer system in a memory, everything in a sequential pattern. The structure, it can be look like this. You can observe here. Because here, you can implement the circular queue using array only. So when you are going using array, the starting index is 0, then 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if you think about this particular queue, now how will you implement this queue? This you can implement using an array. What should be the size of the array? The size of the array depends on the number of elements you want to store in the queue. So here in this example, I can store the data from 0 to 7 location. 0 to 7 means totally 8 elements I can store. So the size of the array should be 8. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 0. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So up to this place you can replace. So you can declare an array whose size is 8. But in the imagination, you have to imagine this way. Similarly, this also. In circular queue, once the queue is full, the first element of the queue becomes real. Remember, in a queue, there are two important indicators. One is front, another one is rear. The two indicators will be indicating whether queue is full or not. So, in circular queue, you will be using these two, as well as in the linear queue also, you will be using these two. These two will be giving the indication that whether queue is full or queue is empty. Now, you please observe here, in the circular queue, once the queue is full, the first element of the queue becomes real. The first element queue become, this is first and this is also real. If and only if the front is moved forward, otherwise it will become overflow. Now, this is my initially the front and rear. When both are pointing to the same place, it is maybe empty, maybe full also. But when they are different from different position, means both are in different place, then queue is having some empty positions. If at all both are just neighbor, front just one step back from rear. That means here, if you observe here, rear at one place, 2, 3, 4, 5, and totally 5 elements are there. Front is at 5th place, then automatically you can say it is full. Front is at 5th place and rear is at 1th place, then you will say it is full because there is no other place to store. Fine. So you have to observe where the front and rear are there. What are the operations are allowed on the queue? One is NQ. NQ means what? Just like inserting an element into the queue is called NQ. Generally, you will say insert queue. But in simplified form, you will say NQ. This is the typical term for adding an element to the queue. Or sometime in exam, they may ask a question. What is the name of the operation when you insert an element to the queue? Then you should say NQ. Okay? Similarly, there is another operation called DQ. The DQ is another name. This name is useful whenever you want to delete an element. Generally, we will say deleting an element from the queue. Or in a simplified form, we will say DQ. NQ related to insertion, DQ related to deletion. So, remove an element from the queue if there is element in the queue. Okay. Similarly, there are two indicators or two pointers. One is front, another one is rear. Front will be always pointing to the first item of the queue, whichever is standing in the front of the queue. That is indicated by front. Similarly, rear also one more pointer, which will be pointing to the last element of the queue. Okay. Front is front part, rear is just opposite of front. So that means back side. Similarly, there is two more standard method, is empty and is full. These are the two methods you can use for checking whether queue is full or not, or queue is empty or not. If it is full, it will return true. Similarly, is empty will return true if it is empty. That means if there are no elements at all. Whenever rear and front both are pointing to the same place, it indicates that there are no elements. Or sometimes it will be full also. Both are pointing to the same place. Fine. Let us have a small a circular queue with set of some item. Initially, when the queue is empty, then we'll say rear and front both are minus 1. The minus 1 indicates queue is empty. This is our logical assumption. Most of, while writing program, you have to put some assumption for emptiness. Generally, in the Python and all, you can write even none. Where in C and C++ Java, you can write minus 1. So, when you say minus 1, it indicates that it is not started. It is empty. It is empty. Now, I want to have a circular queue with 6 elements. So, 6 element means my index will be starting from 0, ending with 5. Ending with 5. So, I can store how many elements? I can store maximum of 6 elements because there are 6 positions. First position, second position, and third position, next, fifth, and sixth. Fine. F is initially minus 1 and R also initially minus 1. It indicates that it is empty. Now, I want to insert an element 6. So, whenever you want to insert an element 6, so where you have to insert? Wherever rear is pointing, but initially rear is minus 1. So, I have to increment first. So, my rear has come here and front also. See, so that means the element 6 has inserted here. Now, I want to insert 12. So, whenever you want to insert 12, so you have to increment the rear. Only for the first time only, the front and rear comes to first place. Next time onwards, only rear is moving while inserting. Now, your goal is what? Insert 12. So, 12 is inserted here. Next, I want to insert 11. Then 11 will be inserted here. Then 7. 7 will be inserted here. Then 14. 14 will be inserted here. Then 10 will be inserted here. So, like this, the data will be inserted. Okay. So, this data is inserted. So, that means my rear is available here at this place. So, this indicates that you have inserted 4 elements. Only which one has moved? Only rear is moving. But front is not at all moving. Because you are doing NQ operation. Remember in NQ operation, only rear is moving. Only for the first time, whenever you have initiated the queue, that time only the front has come front. Okay. Remaining time onwards, it is rear is moving in NQ operation. Or sometimes they may ask a question, in NQ operation, which pointer you have to change or which indicator you have to move, then you should say rear. So, rear always moves forward whenever you are inserting. Now, rear has reached where? At the end. That means, how will you imagine in a cyclic form? You can imagine like this. This is in a cyclic form. First, 6 has inserted. Then, 1 has inserted. Sorry, 6, 12 has inserted, then 11 has inserted, then 7 has inserted, then 14 has inserted, then 10 has inserted. Now, all the elements are inserted properly. Total, there are 6 elements. So, my front is available where? At my 6. And rear is available at this place, rear. Okay. So, that means rear is just one step back of front. So, that means after rear will find again front. So, that means this is which situation? This is nothing but your queue is full. Queue is full. Now, I want to insert 71. Already, you have seen this queue is already full. Means already reached the ultimate, means final position. Now, if you want to insert 71, what will happen? Then you can say it is overflow condition. It is overflow. Or you can say queue is full. You can say queue is full. So, how will you check whether full or not? Whenever rear has reached the last position. Last position and front is still at 0. Rear at last position and front is at 0. Then you can see it is full. Now, I want to dequeue. Dequeue means what? Dequeue means delete the elements. So you can delete how many elements? That depends. You can delete one item, two item, three item, n number of items you can delete. Until means whatever the elements are there, you can delete. If there is no element, finally you can say queue is empty. Now, whenever you want to delete three times, which pointer I have to move? Because I told you in the N queue, only rear is moving. Whereas in the D queue, only the front has to move. So that means first time 6 moved, because 3 times. Second time 12 has removed. Third time 11 is removed. Then after removing this, front has moved. Now currently front is here, because after removing this, 6 has removed, 12 has removed, and 11 has removed, and finally front is available at this place. At this place. So that means how many are there? This is empty place. This is empty. This is empty. And this is empty. These places are vacant. Now I can reutilize. That is advantage of in a circular queue. Where in the linear queue, even though there is an empty position in the front side, you cannot utilize. That is the disadvantage in the linear queue. So in the linear queue, you cannot utilize the previous memories, because linear queue always goes only forward. It cannot come to back. Whereas in the circular queue, it can come back and reutilize the memory. So for memory efficient purpose, memory utilization purpose, always you can use circular queue. That is the advantage. Now I want to enqueue 71. See, in the earlier case, when 71 I have inserted, it was not allowing, it was saying overflow because it was already full. Now if I try to insert 71, where I can insert? Because my rear is here, it can come to front. So I can insert at this place. So 71, I can insert. Yeah, 71 is inserted here. So rear has come to this place. My front is here. Still, how many vacancies are there? Here one vacancy, here one. Still two more elements I can insert. So in this way, memory can be utilized efficiently. Now I can insert some more elements. For example, I want to insert 6 and 21. Which operation? Enqueue operation. Enqueue means what? Insertion. So when I want to insert 6 and 21, so 6 will be inserted here. After inserting, my R is coming forward. There I can insert again 21. Okay. So 6 inserted, 21 inserted, my rear is here now. Okay. Now I want to insert 11. So when you insert 11, rear is already reached here and front is already reached here. So when I am trying to insert 11, it says that there is no more space, you cannot insert. It is also overflow condition or queue full. Queue full. There you cannot insert. So for insertion, you can check a condition. Front equal 0. And rear equal to n minus 1, front is 0 and rear is n minus 1. Means data, front part is here, some data is there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And my rear is n minus 1, rear is here. This is front. If both are, this is 0 and rear is this, front and rear, both are satisfying, or front equal to rear minus 1. Front equal to rear minus 1. Front is here. If front is 5 and rear is at 4th place. Rear is at 4th place. That means both are neighbor. When both are neighbor, that is also full. So you can see circular queue is full. Circular queue is full. This is one case. Another case, if rear equal minus 1, then you can see queue is empty. That means generally rear equal minus 1 and front equal minus 1, it indicates that complete queue is nil. That means nothing is there. First time it is in the beginning stage, no elements are available. So there you can say it is queue is empty. Queue is empty. Else, if rear is n minus 1, then you can say because after reaching this n minus 1, I have to come back. So there I'll say real equal to 0 because your goal is insertion. After reaching here, after finding 5th position, it should come to 0th position. So to come to 0th position, I should write real equal to 0. In the 0th place, you have to insert. Otherwise, if it is not at n the place, then simply rear can move forward or r plus 1 like this. Keep on moving. So, wherever rear is there, in that place, the item can be inserted. Item can be inserted. So, this is a simple procedure for inserting an element into the circular cube. This is one way of writing. There is another way also. You can put a condition like this. R equal to R plus 1 modulus the size. This way also you can write. Because if you write modulus operator, what will happen? That will come to always 0 whenever you reach the boundary. So, this way also we can increment the rear part. Here you have kept like this. If rear equal to n minus 1, then rear equal to 0. Otherwise, rear equal to rear plus 1. So, instead of writing these two line, we can write this way also. R equal to r plus 1 modulus size. Size is what? Size of the cube. Initially, you can define the cube size. Based upon the size of the cube, it will decide what is the next index. Because based on the index, it has to push the data into the cube. Okay. So, this way, it is inserting the similar deletion. Deletion means what? You can remove the element from the circular cube. Remember, these are what? Completely only logical deletion, not physical deletion. Logical, there are two kinds of deletion. One is logical, second one is physical. One is logical deletion, second one is physical deletion. That means logically you are deleting the memory, physically you are deleting memory. So, for logical deletion, you are using, that is possible in the case of array only. Physical deletion possible using the linked list. So, whenever using linked list concept, you can delete the element physically, complete the memory can be deleted. But here, we are using array concept because you are implementing the queue using array. First, you will see the array concept, then we can implement using linked list also. So, in the deletion, if front is minus 1, it indicates that circular queue is underflow or empty. Generally, you say empty, empty is the best word. Generally, overflow and underflow, generally, we can talk in stack. Better you go say either full or empty. Some author of the writing, but better you write empty. Circular queue is empty. Then return. Because now, while deletion, always you have to check empty condition. If queue is empty, you cannot delete anything. That's why you have to say there is no element, you cannot delete. Circular queue is empty. If at all front is not minus 1, not minus 1 means what? It can be 0 or 1 or something. Then there are some elements. So, I can delete wherever front is there. I will get the item. That item you are deleting. How you are deleting? Logical deletion, not physically. That means a logical deletion means what? Only simply you are moving the index pointer. The data is still in the memory. That memory you are not utilizing. Just now kept aside. But that memory nobody else can use. So, my front item is stored in the item. That item is logically deleted. Logically deleted. Now, if the front is rear, then front and rear put minus 1. That means, if there is a single item, assume I am having only 5 in my circular cube. So, front is here, rear also here. Front and rear both are pointing in the same place because there is a single item. When there is a single item, then that will be deleted. Then it should come back. So, again front is minus 1, rear is minus 1. It indicates that still now empty is, my queue is very empty and it is there is no element at all. Queue is completely empty. So, put minus 1, minus 1. This is very rare case comes. That means after inserting the first element, you may go for again deletion. In that case, this scenario will come. Otherwise, if front is not rear, then else what? If at all front has reached to n minus 1, if the front has reached to the n minus 1, that means here, assume 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, front is here and my rear is here. So if you want to delete now this element, front here, my rear here, then you have reached to end, it should come to zero. So here you are putting condition, if front equal to this last element, then front should come back to front position. So it should, because this is the zeroth position, so put zero, so front equal zero. Because front equal zero will come only when you have reached the boundary. Okay, otherwise, if you have not reached end somewhere here, if the front is here, in that case, simply move forward. So front equal front plus one. So this scenario will come if at all we are in the middle. Then you say item is deleted. Item is deleted. Remember, instead of doing this way, I told you in the previous example also, rear case, in a similar way in the front also you can say, front equal to front plus one modulus size. This also you can write. So automatically the front will be moving forward. Similarly, the other methods you can use in your queue, is full, is empty, that means it will say true or false, whether full or not. Full means return true. If it is not full, return false. If front equal 0 and rear equal size minus 1, front 0, rear is size minus 1, that means front is available at the beginning, my front pointer is here and my rear is available here. Size minus 1. What is the size? For example, my size is 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because the index starts from 0. So 0 to 4 means 5. So if the rear is available at 4th place and front is available at 0th place, that indicates that all the positions are filled. For example, here 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That means my complete queue is full. So, it will return true. This condition is true as well as this condition true. Both true. True and true. True. So, return true. This is one case for full. Another case. If front equal to rear minus 1. If front equal to rear plus 1. Front. Assume. Front is here. And rear is here. That means after moving, it has come here, no? It has come here because you have to imagine in a cyclic way. If front is here and rear is just here, assume rear pointer is my here, 7, and front is at this place. So that means after cyclic form, front has gone first and rear. In that case also it is full. In that case also it is full. So there also it will return true. So these two cases you have to remember for the full case. So this will return with the boolean value, true or false. If it is condition true, return true, otherwise return false. Similarly, is empty. Is empty means what? Whether queue is empty or not. If front and rear equal to minus 1, that is empty. If front and rear both are equal to minus 1, that is empty. Because wherever not, when there is a single element, and you are deleting and automatically you are making what? Front minus 1 as well as rear also minus 1. When it is minus 1, then it is empty. So, in that case, it returns true. So, this way you can check whether it is empty or not. Similarly, you can traverse. You can traverse the circular queue. You can put a condition while traversing. Traversing means what? Displaying all the elements, whether queue is having some elements or not. If front is minus 1 and rear is minus 1, then you say queue is empty, nothing to display, no elements are available. Control and go out. Else, next condition, if rear is greater than or equal to front, rear is greater than or equal to front, then you can display the elements from front to till rear plus 1. Display one by one all the elements of the array. But rear means queue. So, this is another way of traversing. Otherwise, if rear is not greater than or equal to front, that means if the rear is less, in that case, I have to go from front plus 1 to n plus 1 till boundary, then from 0 to till the rear plus 1. That means, you are going from these to these, that is first loop, and second loop, 0 to the rear, the second loop. This is first part, this is the second part. Okay? That means this part, nothing is there, so nothing to print, because this for loop goes in this way. So, of course, this is a syntax of written Python. Fine? So, traversing means simply displaying the elements of the circular cube. Display. Traverse means display the elements. Of course, there is another way also. We can start from front. We can start from front until you reach to the rear again. You can put a counter there. You can put a counter. Initially, while inserting the data, you can increment the counter. And while deleting data, you can decrease the counter. So, counter will be always telling how many items are there in the queue. That way also you can do. But this is a simple way also given. So, you can follow this also. Now, see what is the advantage. So, in the circular queue, we utilize the memory efficiently. Remember? Because in the case of linear queue, what happened? You are going always forward only. You will not come backward. Assume I am inserting 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, then 8. I have inserted how many elements? 8 elements. Now there is no place. Here my capacity is up to 8 only. Now, assume I want to delete. This is my rear part. This is my front part. Assume this is a linear queue. This is a linear queue. If I am deleting this element, which element I have to delete? Deleting always delete the front part. So, that means this part is now empty. Assume I want to delete one more. So, my front is here. This I am deleting. So, that means still two elements are free. I am telling this is a linear queue. Now, I want to insert 9. Can I insert 9 here? Because there is no space, I cannot insert. And can I come back? No, you cannot come back. It is a linear. Linear means you have to go only forward direction only, you cannot come back. So, it is not possible in the linear queue. Even though there is a space in the front side, but you cannot utilize the memory. There is a wastage of memory in the linear queue. Whenever there is a space in the front side and the rear has gone forward and it cannot come back. That is the disadvantage in linear queue. So, to overcome that disadvantage, they have come for circular queue. So, in circular queue, you can utilize the memory efficiently. Because in queue, when you delete the element, only front element increase by 1. But the position is not used later. This point you should remember. Most of the time in exam, they may ask a question, why circular queue is better than linear queue? Then your answer is supposed to be, because it will utilize the memory efficiently. So, when we perform more add and delete operation, memory wastage increases. So, in the case of circular queue, you can utilize that deleted area efficiently. Whereas in the linear queue, it is not possible. The biggest disadvantage of circular queue is you can only store the queue length of elements. If you are using it as a buffer, you are limiting your history of depths. Okay. Another small disadvantage is, it is hard to tell empty queue from the full queue without retelling the additional information. So, memory traversing also takes again additional time, because it has to traverse from front to till end, again from beginning to till. So, it may take additional time also. And where you can utilize, it can be utilized in memory management. It can be utilized in the CPU process scheduling, and it can utilize in the traffic system. So, wherever this type of situation comes, you can use the circular queue nature. For example, I have to design an application where only limited items are there. 1, 2, 3. After displaying 1, I should display 2. After displaying 2, I should display 3. After displaying 3, I should display 1. Whenever it is coming in a revolving process, in a cyclic process, then In that case, circular queue is better one. Circular queue is better one. So, this circular queue nature will be useful whenever the memory to be utilized in a efficient way. Okay. Now, you can implement same circular queue using linked list also. See, I told you the circular queue can be implemented either using array or linked list. Circular queue can be implemented by two ways. What are the two ways? Circular queue you can implement by two ways. One is using array. Second is using linked list. In the case of linked list, what happened? Because the first node will be pointing to second node will be pointing to third node. If there are three elements in the circular queue, then the last node's link will be pointing to first node. So, this way you can represent your circular queue. Where in the case of array, you can define an array with size of 3 and you can store the data 1, 2, 3. And these 3 memory array I have to utilize. So, it is in a static memory, where this is in a dynamic memory. So, you can use either static memory or you can use dynamic memory. So, whenever you want to go for dynamic utilization of memory, then always go for linked list concept. Because in the linked list concept, you have to utilize the memory from the heap area. This dynamic memory comes from heap area. Whereas the static one comes from stack area. Remember, there are two types of memory. One is stack, second one is heap. Stack will be useful whenever the predefined size is given. Whenever the number of elements to be stored is known well before, then go for stack. So, array implementation always gets memory from stack. Whereas your linked list implementation, your linked list gets memory from heap area. Because dynamically, you are allocating memory for each node, first node, second node and third node like this. And as and when you need, you allocate memory and then attach. So, this way you can insert. You can insert at front, again insert at end like this. So, the first node will be pointing to second node will be pointing to third node will be pointing to the first node again because it has to go in a cyclic way. But here you need additional pointers. This pointer will be storing the address of the next node. That is also one of the special point you should remember in the linked list concept. Where in the case of array, you need not remember the position. Fine. So, you can implement this either using array or using linked list. So, whenever you are using linked list, what you have to do? Every item of the queue, you have to keep in a node. You have to keep in a node. Inside the node, you have to keep the two things. What thing? One is the item. What item you want to store in the queue, as well as the address of the next node. The link address. So, initially you do not know the address, but the address of the next node. So, what you have to do? You have to store a null value. When you go for second node, that time you will be knowing the address of second node. So, that address you have to store in the first node's link. So, there you have to store. So, this way the linked list will be created. Fine. Now, you have observed here, I think. So, while traversing also, if it is in array pattern, you can traverse this way. If it is in array pattern, you can traverse from 0 to till end. Where in the linked list, if it is same circular queue is implemented using linked list, in that case, how will you traverse? In that case, you have to always start printing from rear pointer. So, start, you can take a temporary pointer T and there you can store the rear pointer, because rear pointer will be holding the address of rear node. After getting the rear pointer, then you can traverse until you reach front. So front will be always your last. So from rear, keep on moving till you reach the front pointer. Because here you are inserting. If you go in this way, it prints in the reverse order. But you have to print from front to rear. So in that case, you can store t equal to front. Then keep on traversing until you reach rear. Until you reach rear. When the temporary pointer reaches rear, then stop it. So you can print the data from front to rear or rear to front also easily. Of course, if it is a single linked list, you will be storing only one address. You can traverse from left to right. Always you better start from front, t equal to front, then move front equal to front of next. Keep on going till you reach the pointer until rear. So when you reach rear, then stop it. So in that case, that will be still better. Most of the time, they may ask the questions, what is the best data structure to implement circular queue? So you can say either array way or linked list way. In array way, it will be useful whenever the size is well defined, which will not deviate. Maximum size, if you know, which will not change at all, then go for array. If the size is not known, in that case, always go for the linked list pattern. So linked list pattern will be better if the size of array or size of the queue is not known. How many items you want to store, if you are not aware, in that case, go for linked list. Because dynamically you can add or dynamically you can remove. For that sake, linked list is the better one. Is it clear? I hope this way you can do the operations. But here, in terms of the time complexity, if at all you want to insert the item into the circular queue, then you are traversing from front to till rear. Because wherever rear is there, you are inserting. Wherever rear is there, you are inserting. So the time complexity will be order of 1. Because you are reaching to end and inserting. Already rear pointer is at that place. At that place you are inserting. That's a fixed amount of time. If the location is known well before, because you are going there and directly inserting, so that's your order of 1. If at all you are starting from beginning and going and reaching end and inserting, then you are traversing end time, then you are inserting. In that case, order of n. But here, rear pointer always knows the rear node's address. So in that case, the time complexity will be order of 1. So that means you are inserting with the help of rear pointer. If at all you are inserting through with the help of the front pointer, in that case, you have to take order of n time. Okay. So this way, you can do the all operations on circular queue. So remember, circular queue also one type of linear data structure. So I think you have seen the various types of linear structure. I think you can recall what are the linear data structures. One is stack, queue, linked list. Here all comes under linear data structure. This queue may be a circular queue or may be a linear queue. Both are linear in nature only. Okay. So this way you can do all your problems. I hope all these things are clear now. So remember, this is the time complexity, order of one, and mostly you can say order of one because you know the rear pointer. Sometime in exam they may ask, if I use front pointer, I want to insert, then in that case order of n. Similarly, if you want to delete, if you want to delete the element, in that case, order of 1 only. Why? Because you know the front pointer. This is for insertion, this is for deletion. Okay. So, this way you can solve. Okay. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.